read?
Let's check.
Why have you got loads of change like this in your flight?
I'm Abby Skelly, functional skills tutor for catering.
Start, you have to go for an encounter and make sure you have exactly that amount.
I teach mainly functional skills and I'll be teaching GCSE as well next year. We're in, it's a fully functioning restaurant and members of the public come in for teas, coffees and lunches and dinner. And it's a chance for the students to learn all the skills that they need for industry. So we've got seats where customers come in, order teas, coffees, and students have to take their orders, and they also have to work out how much their bill is. And if staff members come in, they have to work out a 10% discount for staff as well, so there's a bit of percentage involved.
There you go. Lovely, thank you very much.
That's okay. There's also a bar area, so that's where the students make coffees and make drinks. And they're dealing with measurements, they're dealing with sort of percentage alcohol content in wine, and that's something we cover in functional skills lessons. There's also the hatch, which is just a bit further up, and that's where they sell all the food from the kitchen at reduced prices as well. So that opens from 9 o'clock to 1 o'clock, and if it's getting to 12:30 or something and they haven't sold out of everything yet, then they might reduce their prices by a third or something like that just to help them sell. And the other thing they do in here, there's an appointments diary at the front where customers come in or ring up and book times, so they have to be on the phone, so they're working on their English communication skills, and they're also making sure they write down the booking and the time of how many people and that kind of thing, so it's all maths involved there as well, making sure they haven't got too many bookings in one slot and working out how long the table is going to be there for. At the start of the year, a lot of them come in and sort of they're quite negative towards maths because they've done it through school and they're sort of, yeah, a bit fed up, and then they have to do it again at college, so they're even more fed up. But they do sort of, because they're in our department here and I teach maths and I'm attached to the catering department, so the maths I try to do in my maths lessons is related to what they would be doing in the restaurant or in the kitchen and that kind of thing. So often they're quite surprised. They go, oh, we were doing this the other day in the restaurant. And they see it sort of come up in their maths lesson and then come up in the kitchen, and then they link the two together. And I think sometimes when they've had that, they've done it in the lesson and they've done it in sort of a maths environment. And then when they get the chance to work on it in real life, I think that helps it to sink in. In the class with me, we work on percentages, but also when they come into the restaurant, and a member of staff was talking to me today about how they have to calculate like business costs and things, so they work out a percentage profit that they'd made as if they were a business. The good thing is because I'm sort of attached to this department, if staff have got something coming up that they're concerned about, they might ask me a way they can break it down and make it easier for the students to do. And then I might be able to run a lesson alongside, so it just reinforces what they've been doing, so they kind of get a two-way approach at it. And often staff will come up and ask for different ideas, different tips of what we actually do in maths and what kind of things they need to be embedding into their sessions. One of them's created like a timeline planner for in the kitchen, so because the students often struggle with time and working out when it goes over the 60 minutes, how to add it on in hours. So he's done a timeline planner for them in the kitchen where they start at 9 o'clock and they plan what they're going to be doing sort of every 10, 20 minutes and how long the activity will take, and to get them up to 12 o'clock. So what time things need to go in the oven, what time they need to come out of the oven, how long they need to be prepping veg for and that kind of thing. So say they'd put their cakes in the oven and they need to be in for 35 minutes and they put them in at sort of 10 to 10 and then they've got to sort of work out that the 35 minutes would go over the 10 o'clock mark. So it just helps them, especially when they go over that hour mark. I work closely with the tutors to make sure they're getting maths from all angles, really.
Got it? Do you need the little menus?